Bleach episode 32 is coming this week, and I could not be more excited. Of course, we have the spoilers from the official Bleach page. We'll be talking about the screenshots, and also to the one person or two people on Twitter that decided to show me this episode's leaks of Riruka. I hate you. But anyway, with that being said, we're going to talk about this episode. A lot to talk about and a lot of speculation. So hit that like, that subscribe, and of course, let's get into these spoilers, shall we? So first and foremost, as you know how this goes, we talk about the synopsis first and then the images. So let's get right into this bad translation that I have got. Right, here we go. The Shinigami try to regroup and fight back, but as if in mockery, the cityscape of the Unseen Empire, being the Vendome Rai, that covered the Serate is peeled back and lifted up, as we saw at the end of the episode. Meanwhile, Ichigo is returned, or reunited, with NELIEL and Grimmjow Jagajax, with whom he had a fight with a fierce battle in the past. He is also joined by the Fallbringers, Riruka, Dokugamine, and Yukio Hans Versipipis. Yeah, I'm not saying that. Ichigo and his team once again head for the Rayo Palace to swoop down on Yuha Bak. Now, of course, this synopsis is the intention rather than what actually happens. Obviously, saying things like Ichigo and his team once again head for the Rayo Palace to swoop down on you. So it's the intention that this is what they're going to do. This is their plan. And obviously, they have the help of Riruka and Yukio, which, of course, I hope they have some really... I need to see... Wait, where's my camera? I need to see Riruka's bunny flaps. I want full Sakuga. I want skirt flutters. I want butterfly wings. I need the fucking hats, ears. I need all that. I need everything. I want the best. The funny thing is about this episode too, and again, I'm not going to pretend like I'm a Sakuga guy or a guy that knows animators like that or their portfolios. I just go with what essentially people say or their kind of response to it, and I look at the names. I'm like, okay, yeah, I've heard of these guys before. They're pretty good. And for some reason, in this episode particularly, there's a lot of good animators. Now, not to say, obviously, I don't want to say that there's no good animators in the other, obviously, episodes, right? But what I'm saying is, for an episode which I didn't expect to have a lot going for it, there's talent on here that is a bit odd to me. So I wonder what is going to be in the episode that's really going to not justify but show us, right? Is it going to be character acting? Is it going to be environmental change that's really going to change the scope of why these people are needed, right? Yeah, let's get into the images, and then we can kind of just go from there, right? So first and foremost, we have, of course, Grimmjow. Because obviously last episode we have Aizen, so having Grimmjow come in this episode, is just like a girl's fan favorite. So this is just fan service for girls, let's be honest. But I will say, I want more lore. I want more sense of relief that things are going to go the way that we want it to. And then, of course, we have NELIEL coming very close to that as well, because NELIEL does literally show up. Spoiler alert, right? NELIEL shows up, right? It's in the image, but she shows up right after Grimmjow. And there's some comedy there. I hope they keep the comedy. I think that's important. But I want to say that NELIEL looks absolutely gorgeous. And what I mean by this is that you never really notice a difference until you see the anime version of it. And what I mean is that the old anime, her hair was kind of like teal or turquoisey-ish. And this is just straight green. So the difference, obviously we saw Kid NELIEL with like green hair, obviously, but to see NELIEL with this hair too, it just looks so much better. So obviously we're going to get two back-to-back characters, one for the girl Kumas, a girl for the boy Kumas, right? So everyone's winning with waifus and husbanders, right? Let's get that out of the way for stars. Then of course we have an Ichigo of Ichigo and the crew. This is clearly, I obviously know what this panel is. It's the panel of like the Prefaces world or the Dongai or the space in between or around the Dongai opening up. Why can't I remember what that is? But it's opening up, and this is where everyone's seen what basically the Soul Society is essentially turned into. And in the back, you can see Yukio's space. So this is the space that they're going to be in. Yeah, I've got no complaints. This is a very manga accurate image. Next, we have the spirit orbs. I don't know why, like, my memory was kind of getting confused the last live reaction that I did, because I was like, isn't the spirit orb supposed to be around? And I mean, to be honest, if I remember correctly, things were changed within that episode because they should have been holding the spirit orbs last episode when they were showing, like, the Shinigami and Quincy's coming together to open the portal. So that's where it kind of fried my mind a little bit. But they are making their appearance. It isn't a rainbow orb like BBS has done. I feel like they missed the boat a little bit. I feel like they should have, but having yellow Reishi or a yellow white yellow ball, I mean, it works, right? It's a spirit orb. So we got the spirit orbs. This is obviously to open the gates. And then, of course, we have an image of Hoshwa, which is basically the most generic image ever. And I would just imagine that this is just a reaction shot. Or maybe this is where Yuha maybe goes to fall asleep. And this is like an image of where maybe Hoshwa's like, okay, like, I'm in charge now. I'm not fully sure, but I think it's a good set of images. I think it builds hype for NELIEL and Grimmjow, of course, to see Ichigo and the squad kind of excited and gassed up. We get to see the spirit orbs, but I think the most detail, unironically, comes from the synopsis, because the synopsis itself talks about the main thing, which is, but as in mockery, the cityscape of the unseen empire that covered the Sote is peeled back and lifted up. So, of course, the spoiler side of this is that everything is, you know, everything's looking lifted up, everything's looking, everyone's regrouping, everyone's getting together, everyone's creating a gate to get to the Soul King's palace. But because the world is now being reshaped as, like, essentially almost one, you're now gonna see the difficulty, which I would imagine is gonna be on the second half of the episode. So I'm not quite sure where this is gonna end primarily, to be honest. I think they've got a lot of, how can I say that? I feel like they've got a lot of, in terms of a direction, it's not gonna be action-packed episode, but it's got to be a very dramatic episode. And I feel like if they can touch on that dramaticness of the world changing and that bit of hope that was built up from last episode now gets, like, shut down again, I feel like the episode's done its job. And again, there's a lot of good animators on this episode, so I'm wondering, like, if that's the reason why, is because there's so much environmental change. And of course, we're going to probably see the black sky that we see in the trailer, and probably where the purple hues are coming from. I think it's from the crystals of, like, the Quincy remodeling. So I'm very excited. But of course, this episode is going to have a great Riruka moment in it. I'm going to come and you guys aren't going to stop me, right? It's going to be an amazing thing. So tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of this episode. Are you excited? Where do you think it's going to end? Because, to be honest, a little bit baffled, but we should be going into, I won't say next episode, but I would say maybe the episode after, we're gonna maybe start, is it Baby Hold Your Hand that comes first, or would it be the Basby flashback? I'd have to double check that one. But with that being said, I'm gonna catch you more focus later, you guys. Of course, have this fine day, Jaymes Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.